a reverse situation in the beginning rather than try to fight for it later on when they call you or they ghost you.
You don't want it to come up after. You want to handle it right away.
Yeah. Jessica, you know what? I love talking to you and meeting your lovely son. And this is just so great. And I'm so glad we're going to be working together. And everything is planned and we've scheduled and we've taken care of the money and everything. Let me ask you something, because this was, you know, we just met. This was our first phone call and we've both made commitments. Are you comfortable with this? Because we got to this decision to solve all those problems for you for 2024. We did this pretty fast. Are you okay with all of this?
Yeah, I really feel like we just really connected and you kind of get me and I feel really good about it. Yeah, I'm ready to go.
I feel good too. And thank you. You're very kind. I love working with clients like yourself. So you're okay. You're not going to call me tomorrow and tell me you've had a change of heart or it's the holidays or your baby's mad at you because you made a commitment to your Uncle Claude or something like that, right?
No, and thanks for asking about that though, because yeah, no, I feel good about it. I don't have to think about it. I'm
okay.
ready to go.
And you're the kind of person I like to work with. You have a lot of character. I know when you make a commitment, you keep it. I just get that feeling about, oh, that's called a super stroke, by the way. what do you think your competition is going to do stuff like that? Is it called guts for a reason? How scary is it to go to the same prospect you've just been working your butt off to sell and then go to them and say, you can't, are you okay with this? You can say, if you're going to say no now. You're not going to call me tomorrow. How scary is that?
Freaking out, man.
But I'll tell you what, you've just reduced the chances of rejection by about 99%. You got to be brave in sales. Sales is really brave. Let's anybody else? I skipped over Bill Pinnell and Wade. Did you guys have something you wanted to say? I was rude to you before. I'm sorry.
No, you're making me blush a little bit. I don't know if I'm that smart, but I think for me, just being really analytical, I think it just takes a lot longer for things to sink in. Like I've been following you for a long time before, I became your student. So, I guess for me, it just took a while and it's like, I can figure this out myself and I've got all these recordings that I can listen to Claude, you know, and all these YouTube videos. So, I could figure out what he's talking about and I don't need to do some kind of mentorship program, but, you got to me though.
it works both ways. It changed my life. Literally, I was the traditional door knocking sales guy. I worked for a Fortune 500 company. They just said, basically throw a lot of stuff against the wall and see what sticks. And it was very frustrating for me. It was time wasting. I need that emotional response. I need the reward. How many people are that honest that can you just work and work and work without getting a reward, getting compensated? I can't. Does anyone else feel like that? You got to get a reward. Even if you're a missionary, you got to get a reward sometime, don't you?
The leaky gas tank, you know, and it might've been, I learned about this on this, in this group, the leaky gas tank, because if you don't get a result really quickly, eventually all that gas will leak out. You gotta get that result or that reward, that paycheck, that closing, that deal to go through very quickly, because we only have so much rocket fuel in our systems and something's got to get us back up there. We can, like, that's why I scheduled that, last week. Cause I was like, I was starting to lose the motivation, the faith. And I know this works, but I got a lot of rejection last week. And I was like, thank God my wife was being nice to me all last week, or I would have just been really in the gutter.
How do we handle rejection real quick? When you get a prospect, you know you're not going to sell them. You can't get them over a 2 or a 3. They don't have the need. They don't have the money. They're being snippy or rude to you. What do you do with that prospect Very. I'm looking for. What do you do with that prospect after 3-4 minutes?
Fire them.
How do you fire somebody? What? How do you save your ego? How important is protecting our ego, our self-esteem, our confidence in business? It's huge. If we get rejection all day long, it just sucks the life force out of us. Okay. So you've got to, one of the most beautiful things I think about my system is we get to fire the prospect. They don't reject us. We just acknowledge, hey, you know what this, you know what, Bill Pinnell, I don't think you and I are a good fit. I really appreciate talking, and I'm going to send you a little gift. I'm going to send you a free book in the email as soon as we get off this, but I think it's over for, but I think it's over. And I think it's over. So I wanted to wish you and your family the best of the season. I don't think we're going to do business. I know you want to think about it and call me later and check out my competition, but I just get the feeling that it's over. What do you have any, how do you feel about that?
You know, Claude, I would like to work with you, but I just don't see it happening.
I don't either. I don't see it. So listen, if you can't say it, I will. It's over. And listen, I want to wish you and your family the best holiday. I only make an offer once to do a deal, a real estate deal, to offer coaching or something like that to people. It's either right from the very beginning or it will never be right. So you have a great holiday. I'm going to send you a little gift. If you do want to get back to me before 4:30 this afternoon, I'll keep my offer open. Otherwise, I wish you well. Bye-bye.
But. No,
click. Click. It's over. I really, this is the way I end it. And you were doing the butts. Thank you, by the way. You know, we don't rehearse these role plays. There's what Bill wanted to get the last word in, but I got off the phone. I fired him. I was very polite. Wasn't I Claude polite just now? My good manners. Yes. Okay. And I sent him a gift and I wished his family and everything. What's going on in Bill's role play head right now, Bill? What do you think's going on?
He just rejected me.
Yeah, he just rejected me. I wanted to stick it to him and tell him, forget it. I've had a bad day today.
Why is it so important for the gut salesperson to use your words, to stick it to them rather than to be the sticky? Do you want to be the sticker or the sticky?
You want to be the sticker because like Brent was saying, you get rejected all the time. It starts wearing on you. But if you can turn around and fire people, that's going to make me, I live to fight another day.
Say that again.
Make another
call. Say that last part again. If
I live to fight another day.
Yeah. Yeah. We've got to protect ourselves in a world, in a competitive world where we can get countless rich. I know why people fail, because no one wants to suffer through the pain of embarrassment and rejection all day long. We're human beings. We're emotional creatures. Are we through evolution or whatever you believe? Do you think that we're built with emotions inside? Do you think it's part of our chemicals, our physiology, emotions?
And we don't want to be kicked out of the tribe. You know, we like, because that was survival, 150 years ago was the tribe. Now we don't need that as much, but we still have the same mind. So if we're rejected all day long, we can go into a depression and then like, what do? We drink or smoke or whatever our choice is and start trying to medicate ourselves. But yeah, it's because of that, that 2024 year old brain we have. Yeah. So yeah, it's huge.
It's huge. I wrote a little note here, guys. I actually do notes. Can we make all, we were talking about left brain thinking and the scientific prospect, like Jessica brought that up. Can we make all people and all situations emotional so that we can get the closing results we want?
Why not? Sure.
Why not? Yes.
Yeah.
You know what? It's a horrible expression, but I've heard it before. Even Hitler loved his dog. I mean, we're it's just the way we are. So can we take the person, the cross-examining prospect? Well, Chris Logan, I got a lot of questions for you. You know, I've been to a lot of these seminars. I know I know guys like you, you gurus, you and everything. I got to ask you some questions. Now, right away, what do you know about this prospect?
You know that their walls up and they're very
defensive.
Yeah, very defensive.
And they want to control the process, don't they?
They do. Yeah, 100%.
I want to ask you questions. So in the guts, the minute they start asking you a question, like, this will be your Monday exam, okay? Fast pass or fail. You know, I want to know what kind of contract do I need to do a lease purchase rent to own Brent Bauer's shark land sale deal? What do I need here? What kind of contract do I need?
Or are you asking me or are you asking?
Yeah, I'll ask you.
Okay, cool. You know, that's a great question. And that's definitely something we cover in our coaching. But first, before we dive into that, you know, what's the main reason you're looking to get into land investing?
Well, okay, boom. So what did he do? He turned a question into a question. You mm-hmm. could have gone and just taken the same topic. Mm-hmm. You could have said, why are you interested in contracts? What exactly? Mm. You must have contracts already, right? Or, yeah. You know, what kind of contract are you looking? Have you had a problem with a contract?
Yeah.
I mean, you can go on the internet and find all kinds of contracts. Well, I'm not sure if I understand. I don't know. Mm. You know, can you turn it around? And he might even get madder at you because you asked it. I've had people get madder at me because I answered a question with a question sometimes. And when people get too emotional sometimes, is that good or bad in sales?
That can be bad.
It can be bad. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It can go negative. And that's when you do your stroking and you're, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you. I ask silly questions sometimes. I'm just not sure. Could you help me out? I don't understand why you asked me about contracts. Mm-hmm. You know, could you, and you got to get them talking more than you, you know, you can yep. change. Can we change the emotional state? Can a negative emotional state be transferred into a positive one? There's a heavy duty question. Wow.
Yes, absolutely. Because yeah. then we're starting to feel what their pain is and we can make it better if we can make it better.
Right, can we go ahead.
Some of the best real estate deals I've ever done, the seller has yelled at me before we decided to do business.
Brent, you sound like you're mad at me. Tell me what I did wrong and I'll apologize. I make mistakes. Like, I'm a fallible human being. I don't know what I did wrong, but I apologize. Tell me what I did wrong so I don't repeat it.
Yeah, that's really good. And I didn't have those skills back then. I just somehow or another failed my way through it. But they were just emotional.
This is million-dollar stuff we're talking about today. Let me show you guys. I have a few videos. You guys like videos? Raise your hand if you like videos. I want to show you guys some videos here. If I can find it, let's see if I can find, there it is. Let's find that video. There we go. I'm going to show a few quick videos and we'll discuss them. Can you guys see my screen?
Oh, heck yeah.
Okay, this is one of my favorite guys. Anybody here a Mark Wiens fan? He's just a very likable young guy. He moved to the Philippines and fell in love with a sweet girl there. And he's from Arizona, and he is the most, well, let me show you a video of him just for 30 seconds.
Got two different burgers to try, but this right here, this one is the main event. Say hello to the Wahlburger, our burger. And I got the double. Look at that cheese melting down the burgers. That's impressive. I mean, that's straight up a cheese waterfall. It just makes your mouth drool immediately. Oh, you can smell the beefiness. I got it medium rare. Oh, that's so much cheese. It's oozing. The ooze is absolutely perfect.
What's he doing?
Okay, we got a booth.
What's he doing with the camera? What's he doing with that camera right now while he's eating that burger? What are the words he was using?
He was using very descriptive words, like words that kind of put you right there to where, like, man, I want a burger.
Well, I want a burger. He was using a cheese dripping. It's hot.
Cheese waterfall.
What cheese waterfall. What about the picture he's showing? It's a still, the camera's only showing one thing. Just the burger, nothing else.
Yep.
Are pictures, Can pictures make us emotional combined with the words?
Yep.
Definitely.
How about what does Steven Spielberg do at the end of E.T. with the little boy and E.T. is hugging him and there's a storm in the background and there's a lights flashing? What's the one thing Steven Spielberg adds to raise that emotional moment in that E.T. movie? Music.
Oh, yeah, music.
Can music affect the soul?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So let's see him take. Let me see if
it actually picks up. That is actually remarkable that you can pick it up without it collapsing. It's amazing how the mac and cheese just is cradled within it without it oozing out. What a feat of engineering. Oh man, I think you almost have to eat it and I don't think you can fully extend your jaw to that size. I think you kind of got to take a bite of the burger, then a bite of the top. It's massive, but we'll try.
Tell me that doesn't make you hungry. I apologize to my vegans.
I actually want a burger right now, to be honest.
look at his face.
I'm going down to In-N-Out now.
Look at his eyes.
Cheesy creaminess of the mac and cheese, followed by the crispiness of right the smoked now. Bacon.
isn't that amazing? Is that an emotional response? Could he do a commercial for that restaurant? I think it's Guy Fieri's Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. He's having that burger in right now. Could that be a commercial right there, 30 seconds of just that clip?
Definitely.
Yep.
Is that an emotional or an intellectual? That's purely emotional, isn't it?
And sensory, isn't it? Sensory, yeah. Right?
Let's see something else here. Let's watch this one.
That you're okay, and that maybe
you
can come up.
This one makes
me
cry. Is
it soon enough? Oh my god! Oh god! Daddy! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Makes me tear up every time.
Is that soon enough, baby girl? Daddy!
Yeah, it's me.
It's a dream, please. Don't let them know.
I got to turn it off. I'll need my boohoo tissues in a second. What? Does that touch everyone? That something like that? Especially, you know.
Definitely. You know,
I mean, if you were selling something that related to this, do you think that would... do you think that person would? I'm raising money to bring soldiers home for quick visits with their family. Could you donate anything you have, any loose change you have? Shit, I'd give them.
Crush it.
It'd be blank check time, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
How can I go from a cheapskate 1 second to a guy who says, "Here, take my wallet"?
Yeah.
Connecting with them emotionally.
Emotions.
Emotion is so powerful in sales. You guys like these videos or am I boring you to tears?
No, this is really good.
Let's see. Good. You're going to like this one now. We go to a different emotion. This isn't a life insurance company. Life insurance is really, what are they talking about in life insurance? Really? Death. Right? Mm-hmm. How do you make, can you make death funny? Let's see if they do it.
Uh-oh.
I'm coming home.
Okay. Oh, hey, Snowball.
Nerd alert.
Hello, Father.
You know, Socrates said... Anyways. We'll talk later. Ladder. Life insurance so good, they're gonna want you dead. I love you too, guys.
That is hilarious.
That's amazing.
I've never seen that one before.
I know I make these Mondays look easy, right? But a little bit of work. So can humor be used in emotional selling? What happens when you make another person smile? When you make them laugh?
They trust you more.
Eases tension.
What happens when you touch their heart with an emotional, a little girl seeing her dad has been away in a foreign country serving his country for a couple of years? Brent, I'm going to make you cry pretty soon, right?
Oh, yeah. I was tearing up. That's for sure. I didn't have kids on my last couple deployments, so I couldn't imagine having kids with them. You know, just a couple wives. It was always hard leaving them, but
can I ask you a personal question? You don't have to answer. When you came, you were in the service, and thank you so much. We have such great freedom we take for granted because of guys and girls like you, feel like you good people. When you came, you have what, five kids or something like that?
Three.
Okay, well, next year five, right?
No way. We did. No,
I'm supposed to coach you. when you came home, did you get, were there moments like that?
Oh yeah. It was always, definitely tear jerking, absolute emotion, just crazy emotion.
Oh wow.
Like I remember when my dog said, like, I have a picture of it, on my first deployment, when my dog saw me, it was like, holy cow, you know, just seeing him come and say hello to me.
That's funny you said that. We have not rehearsed this. A hand on the Bible here. Watch this video.
Hi. I miss you. I miss you so much.
That's how they are. I mean, a year for them is like 7 years.
But they remember. They remember. They're intelligent.
I miss you.
They're sentient.
I think.
I mean, this, it just goes on and on. You just won't stop.
I miss you too.
Aren't they great? I love these things. And it's all part of our theme. And it can go from an emotional meeting. It can go from a humorous, it can be humor. It can be so many different emotions. If you can create them through your words, through your stories, through your pictures, through different things, and capture it and create a moment with that prospect, unlike your competition, who's just going to give you academics. Well, it's 13 square feet and it's $8.32, but we finance it at 3% interest. Does that raise any of those emotions like in the videos you've seen here?
No.
No. So does this make sense? Am I, does this really, doesn't this make sense? Let's watch. I found this really, everybody here know Ed Sheeran. He has some beautiful songs. And he did it. I actually found a real, I couldn't believe I found this. Ed Sheeran, name me an Ed Sheeran song. What's that one where the girl's dancing and something?
I can't remember. Thinking Out Loud. I think
Thinking
that's
Out Loud. So many great songs. The guy's a really romantic songwriter and performer. He did a commercial for Heinz Ketchup. Okay.
You know, the food looked good. I just thought there was something missing. So I reach into my bag and I take out the only thing that can complete me. And at that point, the whole world came to a stop. And the waiter was screaming through his eyes. So that's my idea. Do you want to do it?
Why do you think Heinz Ketchup did that? I mean, they could have talked about the ketchup and where they grow the tomatoes and their long history of making ketchup. Why did they do that kind of commercial? Did you pay attention? I love creative commercials. But generally, 99% of them are garbage, aren't they? They bore you or something. Why do you think Heinz had paid a lot of money probably to Ed Sheeran to do a little Heinz commercial? He's very successful, very wealthy, very famous, and a common product like ketchup. Why do you think they put the two together?
Because he was in a fancy restaurant and, you know, all these highfalutin people, and he just gets his ketchup out because he there's something missing, that the je ne sais quoi that he's looking for is in the ketchup bottle, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's just there's so many of these. Let me see if I have one more here. No, I'm not gonna. I don't know if I should show this one. It's slightly offensive. Should I be non-offensive, Claude, today and move on, or should I show the offense? They banned this commercial.
Show button. It.
Do I have the lady's permission?
Go ahead.
Okay, it's a little, you know,
raunchy, a little raunchy.
Yeah, but it's funny as hell.
Okay.
There's a double. I thought
terrible.
That's
terrible. I'm sorry.
It's hilarious.